The special infected in the Left 4 Dead franchise are all very unique, each one possessing special abilities that reflects their names. While the virus has swept across the country, transforming humans into zombies, in some rare occasions, the mutation reaches another stage. This time, we're going to have a look at the Charger. The Charger was designed to quickly separate the survivors with one attack that would drag one person far away from the others. If the Charger runs into more than one survivor, the others will get knocked back. His running speed seems to be the same as the other survivors, but he excels in a burst of speed as he sprints to charge forward with his special attack. While he runs, he will not stop until he reaches a certain distance or smashes into an object or wall. While the Charger's height is similar to the tank, its body type is not as wide. While the tank has very small legs that can barely support its massive size, the Charger's legs have developed enough muscle mass to hold its own body weight. Its skin color has mutated to appear more green. Although it's grown in size, it still wears the clothing it once had before the mutation. It wears a denim-like pair of jeans with overalls, and although it's missing one shoe, it still wears the other one on its right foot. The mutation has caused its right arm to overdevelop, while the left arm has shriveled up and has become useless. Its right arm is so large and heavy that the Charger now slumps over to the right side as it moves. The muscles have overdeveloped so much that its fingers have now become stubby. His left leg seems to have been affected by the mutation more than the right leg. The Charger sprints with its left leg, so perhaps that's why it's grown in size. Because of the Charger's method of attack, it seems his right arm has sustained a lot of damage. You can see battle scars all over its huge arm. The right side of its face seems to have suffered constant damage from charging. The cranium has been dented, he lacks any teeth, and the nose has been removed. While the Charger does make some noises when moving around, it also lets out a loud noise once it starts charging. As it charges forward, it keeps the right arm in the front to smash into anything. If it makes contact with the survivor during the charge, he will grab them and run a good length until it stops or smashes into an object or wall. From here, the Charger would hold onto the survivor and smash them into the ground or into the surrounding area. And just like the other special infected, the Charger does not release a survivor until either he or the survivor is dead. Players using the Charger should make use of a large hole, charging towards a survivor and bring them over the edge for an instant death. The sacrifice you make here will pay off, as you'll be able to respawn to assist your team, while the survivors cannot respawn. Since the Charger is so large, it's best to use them with ambush techniques, hiding in the bushes, or charging through doors or narrow hallways. Charging from too close of a range might not affect the other survivors that much, as it will just cause them to stumble. Therefore, it's better to charge the group from a longer range to build up momentum. This will cause you to knock down the other survivors you run through, but keep in mind that once you start charging, you cannot change the direction, so your aim has to have good timing. During the development of the Charger in Left 4 Dead 2, it was supposed to be a large zombie with an armored skull and tiny T-Rex arms, or it was going to appear as a dog with a tripod design. The final version did eventually take some of these ideas. It does only have three functional limbs, there are two legs and one arm, while the left arm is floppy and does not function at all. They also used a reskinned Hunter model just to test out the ideas of the Charger. This also gave them time to come up with the sounds for him. Its temporary warning call was, "Ai, ai, ai." This was stated in the developer's commentary. Its attacks were also undergoing different changes. His melee attack used to be an overhead strike to smash the survivors into the floor before pounding on them. Its right arm would be used in a lunging formation. His skin was also supposed to appear more bloody, while the face exposed part of its skull. This, of course, was changed in the final version. A body of the Charger can be seen in the first chapter of the Swamp Fever campaign. It is hung in the shape of the Greek character Lambda. It's a similar shape to the logo used for the Half-Life video games. So that's it. That covers the Charger in Left 4 Dead 2. If you enjoyed this video, then leave a like rating on it. If you want to see more videos like this, then subscribe and turn on notifications. Thanks for watching. My name is Acid Glow, and I'll see you in the next video.
Shoot the charger!